Welcome back to another video, guys. This is part two of our trip through Victoria, Sydney, New South Wales, and back to Brisbane. Before we get to the Murray, we went to Craig's hut. I'm going to show you all of those clips right now. Enjoy. G'day, guys. We've just woken up to go up to Craig's hut. Craig's hut is a little hut up on top of a really high mountain that was in the Man from Snowy River movie that my mum and dad both love and grew up watching every day. So we're heading up there and we'll get some drone footage, some GoPro footage up there. So yeah, enjoy the drive up there and then the drone footage. You stole my heart of gold after my silver soul. Can you dig any deeper now? I gave you all I own, put you on this golden throne, but I'm a little stronger now. You cashed in on my promises, you know I'm too generous. Now I've learned to never help you out, 'cause I'm done cleaning up your mess. Found myself in my regrets. I've become a little stronger now, a little stronger now. Climbed Mount Stirling for about 45 minutes on a dirt road. For the first part, you could get here with a Corolla, but then there's a 1.7 kilometer walking track that you can stop before the full drive track starts. But the full drive track, you can get here in like your Subaru XVs and your RAV4s and your foresters and that sort of stuff. You don't need an actual four-wheel drive to get here. Finished all our filming for today at Craig's hut. There won't be any more filming until we get back to the thing.
Tim!
How you going?
Dad, I mean,
we'll film on the way back down the mountain, but that's about it for Craig's hut.
Bye!
What are you doing?
We're heading to the Murray today. It's only about a 2-hour drive from Mansfield. G'day guys, we have arrived at Echuca, the Murray River. We've arrived at the Murray River fine after a quick two-hour drive along the highway, some just two-lane roads. We've made it to the third largest navigable river in the world. It's 2,500 kilometres long, and yeah, we'll get some quick photos of it. We're gonna get some drone footage later, but yeah, that's about it. We won't be doing much here. Tomorrow I'll film us when we go on the paddle steamer, but from there I'm probably just gonna end off this part two, which is gonna be the final part, because after the Murray there's nothing else we're doing apart from driving back to Sydney and then driving back to Brisbane. So yeah. G'day guys, I hope you enjoyed all of that drone footage of the Murray and the Emmeloo. We are now on our last day in the Murray, in the Echuca area, and we have just come to the Aussie beer shed. We got toured and had a little bit of a tour of the first little bit of the place. I'm gonna do some cinematics and some nice shots of everything we go past that I think is worth it. So after this, I'm probably gonna end off the video. So enjoy this last bit of the video.
Oh, it's a lonesome away from your kindred and all, by the campfire at night, where hear the wild dingoes call. But there's a nothing so lonesome, morbid or drear, than to stand in the bar of a pub with no beer. Now the publican's anxious for the quota to come, and there's a faraway look on the face of the bum. The mate's gone all cranky and the cook's acting queer. Oh, what a terrible place is a pub with no beer. Then the stockman rides up with his dry, dusty throat. He breasts up to the bar and pulls a wad from his coat. But the smile on his face quickly turns to a sneer as the barman says sadly, the pub's got no beer. Then the swaggy comes in, smothered in dust and flies. He throws down his roll and rubs the sweat from his eyes. But when he is told, he says, "What's this I hear? I've trudged 50 blamin' miles to a pub with no beer." Now there's a dog on the veranda, for his master he waits. But the boss is inside, drinking wine with his mates. He hurries for cover, and he cringes in fear. It's no place for a dog, round a pub with no beer. And old Billy the blacksmith, the first time in his life, why, he's gone home cold sober to his darling wife. He walks in the kitchen, she says, "You're early, Bill dear." But then he breaks down and tells her the pub's got no beer. Oh, it's hard to believe that there's customers still, but the money's still tinkling in the old...
Thanks everyone for watching this video. This has been a trip, this has been a trip. And I know they're sincere when they say they don't care if the pub's got no beer. So it's a lonesome highlight, so I hope you enjoyed those clips. Thank you for watching this video. I'll see you in the next video.
But there's nothing so lonesome, morbid or drear, than to stand in the bar of that pub. As the barman says sadly, the pub's got no beer. Then the swaggy comes in, smothered in dust and flies.
So you like
he throws down his roll and rubs the sweat from his
and
eyes.
Subscribe to here.
But when he's told, he says, "What's this I hear? I've trudged 50 layman miles to a pub with no beer."